Hello everyone, I've explained how to create an environment and toolchain for ESP-IDF. In this video, I start FreeRTOS series. Starting with FreeRTOS could be hard for beginners, but in ESP-IDF, almost each example uses FreeRTOS libraries, so that we should learn it at the beginning. I'll try to explain its usage so slowly, so I hope you will understand the usage of it. Additionally, you can ask anything about FreeRTOS library on comment of the video. I'll help to you as soon as possible.
Let's start the machine.
Firstly, let's start with meaning of FreeRTOS. Free is, as you know, something we don't have to pay, and mean of RTOS is real-time operating system. We have computers, smartphones, actually all of them work with RTOS. You know, we have an app main and error code, and ESP runs each line with in order. However, we have only main function, so we couldn't different duties on the same time. This component helps us exactly this issue. Thanks to RTOS, we can create main tasks and they'll work at the same time. Actually, not at the same time, but this library pass from one task to another task with high speed, so it looks they're working at the same time. Normally, we can create a while loop on the main function, and it repeats itself forever. But with this library, we can create multiple tasks and their infinite while loops will work at the same time. This is how it works on our computer or our mobile phone. For example, you can listen a music when you're surfing on the internet or making a call when you play a game, etc. These are another tasks, and this event is similar with FreeRTOS. Of course, your computer's phones uses more stronger RTOS library than FreeRTOS, and they have more powerful processor than microprocessor. But working principles are same. In this video, I'll start with overviewing FreeRTOS on ESP-IDF and what's the usage reason of some functions. An important thing, I'll use ESP32, but these functions are same or similar for STM32, Microchip PIC, or Arduino. So, you can use FreeRTOS on different microcontrollers, but I think it mostly suits ESP-IDF because it has stronger and faster than these. Especially on Arduino and PIC, using FreeRTOS may cause a slowness to working process because they work 10 times slower than ESP32. Let's start with official website of FreeRTOS. As you can see, there are lots of useful information about FreeRTOS. You can check this website for deep learning. Let's check supported device from here. As you can see, there are lots of controllers that work with RTOS. Some ARM Cortex, Atmel, and Extensa, which is used with ESP32. Some PIC, some Nordic Semiconductor controllers, STM, also, there are tutorial and reference manual, you can check this, but don't forget it, ESP-IDF uses a modified version of Vanilla FreeRTOS, which is 8.2 version of FreeRTOS. Therefore, you cannot use each function on this website. To see specific function for ESP-IDF, let's go to the documents of Espressif. You can choose your version. I use 4.0 and check system FreeRTOS. So you can see the topics on this: task, queue, semaphore, timer and event group. Let's start with tasks. There is a function called xTaskCreatePinnedCore. As you guess, it's used to create task, but we can choose which core will run the task. As I mentioned before, ESP has two cores. So you can choose one of them and write one function as 0 or 1. This is also used to create a task, but we don't need to choose a core. These functions use static memory. You don't need to learn it for now. This is used to delete a task. This is used to create a delay. It will be used approximately each example. When we create a task, we determine the priority of this task. The meaning of it, we can manage some task with higher priority. Then the microcontroller will give the first priority to this task. It's the version of getting priority task on interrupt service routines. I'll explain it later. We can set the priority of task after creating it. This function is used to suspend a task. It means task will stop until another task will resume it. We can resume a suspended task with this. This is for interrupt. This is used to suspend all tasks that running. This is used to resume all suspended tasks. This is also a useful function. We can get how many time has passed from starting of the app. This is used to get number of tasks. As you can see, there are lots of functions can be used for tasks. I've explained the functions that we'll use on many examples. Let's jump to queue. We use this API to send a data from a task to another task. We use the send function to send a value and use give function to get this data. Let's jump to semaphore. Difference between semaphore and queue is one of them as a flag, the other one works to send a data. So we can use semaphore on some conditions, like whenever some issue happened on task 1, do something on task 2. Queue is used to give a data to another task. Semaphore give notice to another task. We use this function to create it. We use this function on the task that we would like to receive the notice. This is, as you guess, check it with a period. This is used on a task which we use to send notice. This sends with a period. This is used by interrupt. It's also used by interrupt. This is what semaphore done. Let's jump to timer API. We can use this timer API to reload a data with a specific data. For example, we have an integer and we would like to make it equal to 0 each 10 minutes. It's not used so frequently, so I won't explain function of it. Let's jump to event group API. We can use this with condition statements. For example, an integer can be 0 or 1. We create an event group and set bits with this integer and On the other task, check its value with weight bits. I want to explain it with an example. It's a Wi-Fi situation example that published on ESP-IDF. As you can see, it created an event group, then set it with fail bit or connected bit. And on another task, it checks the bits and make a condition statement with it. Finally, I have explained usage reason of these functions. On the next video, I'll start with example of task API.
That's all I am going to talk about today.
Stay motivated and subscribe me. Let's control the controllers together.